Oh, Jesus, I give you glory, Lord. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus today. Oh, 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 oh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. I give you praise, Lord. I give you glory, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, this morning, Lord. I bless your name, Lord. Even so, Lord Jesus, come. Even so, take your bride away. How my soul long to be with you. Thank you, Jesus, this morning, Lord. As I come in your presence, Lord God, I give you thanks this morning, Father. As I come in your presence, Lord God, I give you praise this morning. Lord, you are worthy of praise this morning. You are worthy of honor. You are worthy of all glory this morning, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, I exalt your name this morning. As I come in your presence, Lord God, I give you praise, Lord. For you are worthy of praise this morning. You are worthy of honor this morning, my Father. King, my Master. I worship you this morning, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 Lord, thank you, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy of praise this morning. Hallelujah. As you're coming on, just come worshiping this morning. As you're coming on right now, just tune in. Tune out everything else and tune in to the Spirit of God this morning. Tune in. We're going into the presence of God this morning. Where there's fullness of joy. Come into the presence of the Lord this morning. Let us give Him praise this morning. Lord Jesus, we magnify your name this morning, Lord. Lord Jesus, we come against everything that would want to mess up the worship today in the name of Jesus. We come against everything that would want to mess up the worship today. We come against distraction right now in the name of Jesus. On this web, on this net right now. Father God, we come against every distraction of the enemy that would want to distract us from getting into your presence this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We magnify your name this morning, Lord. We glorify your name this morning, God. We invite your presence. We invite your presence on this page and on this video right now in the name of Jesus. You are welcome. You are welcome, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you this morning, Jesus. We give you praise, Jesus. We're building an atmosphere of praise this morning. Atmosphere of his presence this morning. Nothing will get no other glory this morning. Nothing will get the glory this morning. Nothing else but the Spirit of God will get the glory this morning. We're going into his presence. So we're putting ourselves aside. We're putting our situation aside. We're putting our complication aside right now. And we're getting into the presence of the Lord. Because at the presence of the Lord, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord this morning. What does it mean to get into the presence of the Lord this morning? What does it mean to get into the presence of the Lord? What does presence represent this morning? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What does a presence represent this morning? It's a person or thing that exists or is a present in a place or is present in a place but not seen. That's the presence that we're talking about this morning. A presence that it cannot be seen with the naked eye. But of a surety, when the presence is around, you could feel that something is around you this morning. It's a state of fact. Of existing, occurring. Are being present. Hallelujah. Thank you this morning, Jesus. Oh, I glorify your name this morning. Get into the presence of the Lord right now. That's the presence I'm talking about right now. The presence of God. Where there's fullness of joy. And at his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Get into the presence where nothing else can be seen or get the glory this morning. Get into his presence right now. Get into his presence. Hallelujah. Get into the presence of the Lord. We're going into the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. John 16 and verse 7, it tells us, But I tell you, the truth. But I tell you the truth. It is for your benefit. It is for your benefit that I am going away. Unless I go away, the advocate will not come to you. I'm not talking about no negative presence this morning. No foul presence. You know, this morning, when I got up, right? When I got up this morning, I got up from about, let me see. I got up from about 4:30, 5 o'clock. Because I have a prayer partner, and we just get up 4:30 and pray. Everybody, that's the time that we set because she works. So we get up 4:30 and we pray. We pray in the morning because, you know, that is what we call ourselves. We call ourselves the woman on the wall where we pray for pastors and ministers and evangelists. You understand? Because we know the importance. We know the importance of prayer, and we know the importance of what the presence of God can do in the lives of these men and women of God. So we get up 4:30 every morning and we say we pray. But this morning, you know, I got up this morning and when I got up this morning after the prayer, you know, as I said, when I'm led, I will come on here. I am led right now, right? And before I came on here today, it's like my house not dirty, you know. My house not true because I'm a very clean person. I don't have OCD, but I'm a very clean person. So especially where my environment is concerned. And I got up this morning, and when I got up this morning, it's like God just directing me, instructing me, piece by piece by piece by piece by piece. You understand? And when he was directing me piece by piece by piece, he said to me, wash the wares. And I washed the wares. Then he said to me, clean the fridge. And I cleaned the fridge. All of that I did before I came on here today. And then he said, mop the floor. And I mopped the floor. He said, straighten up the house. You know, but when I was mopping, I was like, I said, God, you ain't easy. Now, why you have me, you know, mopping through, you know, this house not even dirty. And then he said to me, he said, I'm trying to build a presence. I'm trying to build an atmosphere for my presence. I'm trying to build an atmosphere. That's what he told me this morning. I'm trying to build an atmosphere, my God, for my presence to come and dwell. And this morning when I got up, I took a shower, you know. And after I finished cleaning, I was sweaty. And he tell me, go and take a shower. Wash your hair. And dress, because you're coming into my presence. Because you're coming into my presence, my God. He said, you're coming into my presence, my God. Acts 2 says, and when the day of the Pentecost was fully come, when the day of Pentecost was come, they were all in one accord, in one place. My God. Jesus, I love you this morning. I love you, Jesus. I love you this morning, Jesus. Suddenly, there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. I'm talking about the presence of the Lord this morning. I'm talking about the presence of the Lord this morning. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And he said, and there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about the presence of God. Hallelujah. Somebody needs to get into the presence of God right now. You see, when I get into the presence of God, I'm talking about the, you see the presence of God? When you're at a momentum where the presence of God is, no evil cannot come now you're dwelling with that. When you build an atmosphere of praise and worship, discouragement cannot come. When you build an atmosphere of the presence of God, there is a difference, my God. You know, I will always give honor for my woman of God, Evangelist Delima Abili. You know, one of the things that draw me to her, as I've stated over and over, as a woman of God, is that she carries the presence. She carries a presence. And the presence that she carries, it's the very presence of Almighty God. I'm telling you. When you go into that presence, when you go into that, when you find yourself in that presence, no matter how you feel, no matter what you're, it's like you're in, it is resistant. It is resistant. When you build yourself in the presence of God.
And we just love them. They're wonderful.
Thank you, Jesus. It is resistance. You understand? Build up the prayer. Build up your presence. Build up the presence of God. I am not talking about some other presence, you know. Build up the presence of God. When you're in the presence of God, fear cannot take over. Thank you, Jesus. When you're in the presence of God, fear cannot dwell there. When you're in the presence of God, no demons cannot come there. When you're in the presence of God, you cannot take no glory for yourself. Good morning, my sister, my blood sister, Angeline. Good morning, my sister. I love you very much. Thank you for being here. Hallelujah. So when you build presence, how do you build up that presence? It's not every presence is the presence of God. It's not every presence is the presence of God. My God. It's not everything presents the presence of God. My God, this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Build up your presence in God this morning. My God. God loves to dwell with you and me. His presence is there. He cannot come and dwell on an altar that is unholy this morning. Let me just say that. My God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says it is expedient. It is expedient for you that I go away, that my presence will come and dwell with you. Adam and God. Two contrary stories. Adam and God. And then it had Lucifer and God. You see, Lucifer, God built his very presence in him, right? He built him with pipes. He built him with diamonds. With all kinds of shiny apparels. He builded his presence in Lucifer. And the contrast of that is, when the presence of God came on him, he began to glorify himself. He began to look and look at me. I'm so nice and shiny or whatever. And he said, you know what? You see this thing we have in me here? I'm going to be just like the Most High. You know what is messing up plenty of us today? Is that when God build his presence, when God bring us to a place in his presence, he bring us to a place of freedom, of liberty. We begin to glorify ourselves. My God, we begin to forget the maker of the presence. My God, we forget until the presence of God just leave us. Can't dwell with us anymore. It says that God used to come down and he used to commune with Adam in the cool of the day. They used to have a wonderful praise and worship time together. They used to commune together. You see, God knows until when the woman come and when she beguiled Adam. When she beguiled Adam. He came out of the presence of the Lord. Shatarabadikoshia. The presence of God requires obedience. The presence of God requires obedience. The presence of God requires obedience. Because the opposite of obedience is disobedience. The presence of God. And that's a word that we don't want to hear. Holiness. But it requires holiness. The presence of God requires holiness. The presence of God You can't go in the presence of God with anything and go in anyhow anyway. You have to drop off certain stuff. You have to drop off certain stuff. It's an atmosphere of praise. You have to drop praise. You have to drop off fornication. You have to drop off unholiness. You have to drop off unrighteousness. You have to drop off lies. You have to drop off these things to go into the presence of God. because he cannot dwell in a presence. He cannot dwell in the presence of sin. It can't work. So much of us, we want God to come and dwell in us just so. But God doesn't dwell in a vessel that is unclean. God dwells in a vessel that is righteous, that is holy, and that is clean. So much of us, we want to do the things of God. We want to handle the things of God, my God. I'm reminded of the Ark of the Covenant that carried the presence of God. And when they was bringing the Ark of the Covenant to dwell in Jerusalem, David the servant was bringing the Ark of the Covenant from where it was to Jerusalem. One of his soldiers went and just rests his hand on the Ark of the Covenant. Smitten. Meaning he died that day. He died. So much time. Things of God as mediocre. We just want to do anything and everything and expect God to just use us, bless us. But there's a presence that attracts. It attracts God to you. Attracts God. And when it gets into that presence, when you get yourself in that presence, my God, you don't even have to ask God for anything. You don't have to ask God for anything, you know? You don't have to ask him for anything. That is why they try to engage people into worship. Because there's a place when you go in worship, there is an atmosphere that when that atmosphere reach a momentum, demons flee from that atmosphere. Demons tremble. Demons have to run in that presence. People don't want the presence there again. Nowadays, nobody now go after the presence of God. Nobody not going after the holiness of God, the righteousness of God. Nowadays, nobody don't want to even be filled with the Holy Spirit anymore. When is the Holy Spirit is going to build that resistance? Is the Holy Spirit going to bring you to that momentum? My God, this morning. This pig he is signifying by what death he should glorify God. And when he had spoken this, he said unto him, follow me, my God. Jesus is saying this morning, kill flesh. Kill flesh, because flesh cannot glorify in the presence of God this morning. Kill flesh and come in the presence of the Lord. Come into the presence of the Lord. Come into the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. The presence of the Lord speaks in different ways. It speaks in different ways. Elijah. It says, and behold, the Lord passed by. The presence of the Lord passed by Elijah. And a great and strong wind rent the mountains and break into pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. It's not everything, it's not every presence, it's not everything you see. We say Jesus and Lord or whatever, God is in it. It's not everything. It's not everything. It's not everything. It's not everything. Thank you, Jesus. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. My God. God is in coronavirus. God is not in coronavirus. Coronavirus does not represent God. That is of the devil. That comes from the devil. Yes? And after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. Sometimes we get carried away and we hear noise, bam, 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 noise all over the place, and we say, oh, that must be God. That must be God. That must be God. God is not the author of confusion. God is not the author of confusion this morning. God is not the author of confusion. God is not the author of confusion. He's not the author of confusion. And he said, after a fire, a still voice. Hallelujah. He spoke in a still small voice. A still small voice. And when Elijah heard that voice, that was the voice that lifted him up from the place that he was and brought him to the presence of God. Yes. Yes. What it is that is taking you out of the presence of God right now? What it is? What is hindering you from going into the presence of God? What is hindering you? What is hindering you from going into the presence of God? What's hindering you? Is there anything too hard for God to do this morning? Is there anything too hard for God to do this morning? Is there anything too hard for God to do this morning? Is there anything too hard for God to do this morning? Presence. Come into the presence of God. Come into the presence of God, where at His right hand there is joy forevermore. At the presence of God, you don't have to fear. At the presence of God, you don't have to worry. In the presence of God, you don't have to fret. In the presence of God, you have confidence. In the presence of God, you have confidence. He says, I am confident in you, Lord. I am confident in you, Lord. Because in your presence, the song says, in your presence is heaven to me. Jesus was the very presence. Jesus came here on earth and He represented the presence of God. Thank you this morning, Lord. Thank you this morning, God. Get into the presence of God. Get into the presence of God this morning. Get into the presence of God. It's a safe place. It's no worries when you're in the presence of God. When you seek after the presence of God, it's not heavy. It's not heavy. He said, my burden is, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. My God, get into the presence of the Lord this morning. Get into the presence of the Lord. Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before His presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise unto Him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. And in His hands are the deep places of the earth. The strength of the hills is His also. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. For He is our God. And we are the people of His pasture. And the sheep of His hand. Today, if you will hear His voice, harden not your heart, stiffen not your neck. I'm provoking you today. I'm provoking you today. I am provoking you today to get into the presence of the Lord. I am choking you today to get into the presence of the Lord. Sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing. forth his salvation from day to day. My God.
This is what they're singing around the throne of God.
Hallelujah. Honor and majesty. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are his sanctuary. My God. Hallelujah. Give unto the Lord, O ye kindreds of people. Give unto the Lord glory and strength. My God. Sing unto the Lord with the harp. And the with trumpets and sound of cornet, make a joyful noise before the Lord, the King. Come into his presence. Come into his presence. He said, if you don't want to praise me, I will raise up sticks and stones. Sticks and stones. Sticks and stones will never replace my praise. Sticks and stones will never replace my praise for God this morning. Sticks and stones will not get into the presence of God. It will not, because I won't allow it. My God. Don't wait until it's too late. When sickness take over your body, or when judgment come, when the rapture come and gone, you can't sing praise. When you're sick and in the bed, you can't sing no praise. You can't get into the presence of God. But you see, it says it was good for me that I know God from my youth. From my youth, to sing praise unto him. It was good that I was in his presence. In his presence. Because it's like you already have a relationship with God, you know. You're already in his presence. So that when things happen, when these things come, it want to shake your foundation. Because you're already in the presence of God. But if you're not, if your foundation is not in the presence of God, any little wind blow, it's gonna blow you away, no? It's gonna blow you away. Because your foundation is shaking. It says, upon this rock I build, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. When you're in the presence of God, nothing can't harm you. When you're in the presence of God, nothing cannot harm you. Get into his presence. You know why people so anxious and panicking like this? Because they're not in the presence of God. Adam hide. Adam hid from God. Adam hid because he was not in the presence of God. So he hid from God because he was not in his presence. He was not in the presence of God. So that is why some people want to, some people nowadays they want, they're running and they're hiding because Rabadi Koshi Kandi Kusikataya. Listen to me. No, you can't imagine when rapture come. When rapture come, for those that are in the presence of God, and the rapture come and you're taken away, what kind of panic it's gonna have on this earth? My God. When you're in the presence of God, you know so your prayers are going to be answered, you know. You don't have no doubts. You have an assurity. You have an assurity. Come on. Good morning, Maxine. You're going to make it, my girl. I'm speaking to you. Nothing shall harm you. Nothing shall harm you. God gave you that job. God placed you in that job. And God knew. God knew that you was going to be in a hospital working. He knew that. He will cover you. Sister Maxine, God will cover you. Jesus will cover you. Just stay in his presence. And all the nurses and the doctors that are out there now are those in the health sector, in the health field. Just get into the presence of God. Because it is in his presence. It is in his presence. It's only his presence gonna shield you. My God. I'm encouraging you all to get into the presence of God. I'm encouraging man, woman, boy, and girl, and child. Just get into the presence. It's a safe place. The presence of God, in the presence of God, is a safe place. It's a safe place. You're safe. You're safe in the presence of God. Because the Lord is merciful and he's gracious. He's slow to anger. And he's plenteous in mercy. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. And you know what's something about the presence of God? He said sometimes he doesn't always chide with man, you know. But when you know, where you serve, when you know the God where you serve, you know that he will protect you. Have to know the type of God where we have. He said he will never forsake us. And he will never leave us once you're in the presence of the Lord. My God, responsible. God is above principalities and power, you know. God is above disease, pestilence, demons. He make them. He's above it. My God, don't give glory to no disease and no pestilence. Don't give no glory to it. Don't give it. Don't talk about it more than how you talk about the God that you know can deliver you, that would overshadow you and keep you in these times. He says, for he knoweth our frame. He remembereth that we are dust. Ashataya basato. My God. He remembereth that we are dust. God remember say, we are dust. He knows. He knows that this flesh things it cannot take. This flesh cannot retain certain stuff. But it's only when you go into the presence of the Lord. You know that it is your shield and your buckler. It is your protection. It is your mask. It is your coverage. Nashata, get into the present. I am not saying don't go for mass and try to protect yourself and do the necessary stuff. But this morning, mask up yourself in the presence of God. Wrap up yourself in the presence of God. Put on a spiritual mask. Put on a spiritual gadget. Put on a spiritual gadget.
Hallelujah. Give him a standing
ovation. The Lord has prepared his throne. In the heavens. And his kingdom ruleth over all.
Hallelujah.
That's our Father. He ruleth all. Ruleth all. Come on. This morning we give you thanks, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thou makest darkness, and it is night. Roar and their after their prey and seek their meat from God. The sun ariseth. They gather themselves together and lay down in their dens. Man goeth forth unto his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how manifold are thy works in wisdom. Hast thou made them all? Come on. Lord, I give you praise this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody get into his presence. Get into his presence. Get into his presence. Get into his presence. Get into the presence of God this morning. My God. Praise ye the Lord. Praise him. Give thanks unto him, for he is good. Who can utter the mighty acts of God? Who? My God. Thank you, Jesus. A representation back in the days when Moses went down to Egypt to retrieve the people of God under God's command. Under God's command. And I hear plenty of people doing audio of this. You know, but so it was in the beginning, it shall be in the end. And what was the require? One of the requirements that they used was, they said, there was an instruction. There was an instruction. He told the Israelites to use the blood of lambs and mark the doorposts and the doors, and when the spirit of death come, then he says the spirit will pass over it. Back in the days, what is the Spirit of God saying this morning? The presence of the blood. When the death angel come, the presence of the blood, it identify the presence of God. It identified the presence of God. And the death angel would pass over. Get into the presence of God, people. We're in the New Testament now. Get into the presence of God. Forsake the ways. Forsake pride. Forsake pride. pride is not of God. Forsake pride. Put it aside. Ask God, how do I get into your presence, Lord? How do I get into your presence? And get into the presence of God. Get into the presence of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Get into the presence of God. Hallelujah. Get into the presence of God this morning. God is waiting for someone to get into his presence. God is waiting for someone to get into his presence. My God. Thank you, Jesus, this morning. My God. Thank you, Jesus. Get into the presence of God this morning. Get into the presence of God this morning, please. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God. I'm still here. I don't know why. Because somebody needs to get into the presence of God. Somebody needs to get into the presence of God this morning. Forsake your old ways and get into the presence of God this morning. Get out of yourself and get into the presence of God this morning. My God. Get into his presence this morning. Thank you, Jesus. I bless your name this morning, Lord. I bless your name this morning, Lord. You are worthy of praise this morning, Father. You are worthy of honor this morning, Jesus. Because in your presence, that's where I belong. In your presence, oh Lord, my God, in your presence, that's where I'm made strong. Seeking your face, much of your grace. Oh, in the cleft of the rock, in your presence, oh Lord. 'Cause in your presence, that's where I belong. In your presence, oh Lord my God, in your presence, that's where I'm made strong. Seeking your face, more of your grace. Oh, in the cleft of the rock, oh, in your presence, oh Lord, 'cause in your presence, that's where I belong. In your presence, oh Lord, my God, in your presence, that's where I belong. That's where I'm made strong. In the cleft of the rock, oh, in your presence, oh Lord, get in the presence of Lord. Oh, in the cleft of the rock, Oh, in your presence, oh Lord. In your presence, oh Lord. Oh, in your presence, oh Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I sing praises to your name this morning, oh. Hallelujah. For your name is great and greatly to be praised this morning. Come on, somebody get up and get into the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We're getting into the presence of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're getting into the presence of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We're getting into the presence of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Get up this morning. Worship the Lord. Give him praise this morning. Get up from where you are and worship the Lord this morning. Because in his presence, we're getting in his presence this morning. Hallelujah. We worship you this morning, Lord. Lord, we exalt your name this morning. We magnify your name this morning, Lord. You are worthy of praise. You are worthy of honor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We magnify your name. We are in your presence this morning. Cause your rain to fall on us this morning. Take me that place this morning. Take me to that place, Lord. Take me to that place in you this morning, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. For your name is great this morning and greatly to be praised. He is worthy to be praised this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Cleanse me this morning, Lord. Purge me this morning, Lord. Let self be slain this morning, Jesus. Let self be slain this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm trying to get someone in the presence of God this morning. Get into the presence of the Lord this morning. Lift your hands, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in this morning. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. Mighty in battle this morning. My God, give him praise this morning. And watch him do a work in your life. Give him praise this morning and let him bring about a change in your life this morning. My God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I sing praises, Lord. I sing praises, Lord. I worship you, Jesus. Lord, I exalt your name. Thank you, Jesus. It is important for me to be in your presence this morning, Lord. It is important for me in your presence because in your presence, there is fullness of joy. And at your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Close your eyes. Close your eyes this morning.
today, tonight. Close your eyes. Visualize just yourself before God right now. Shut out every other distraction right now. And just go into the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. I sing praises to your name. Oh Lord, praises to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. For your name is great and greatly to be praised. Your name is great and greatly to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I magnify your name this morning, Lord. I magnify your name today, Lord. I exalt you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I magnify your name. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Lord, I magnify your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I magnify your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Just meditate. Just meditate. Think about everything right now in your life that doesn't even make sense. Everything in your life right now that doesn't make sense. Everything in your life now that is just hurt and pain and just distraction.
Sing with me.
Just get rid of those things right now and just focus. Focus on God right now. Think about His goodness. You
sick this morning. You are not sick this morning. You're not in the hospital. You're not under the cold clay. Even if you don't have a roof over your head, you're still is alive, so there's hope. Find something to just give God thanks for. Just find something to give God thanks for. There must be something that you can give God thanks for this morning. Hashataya.
Many waters, friends, at the sound of worship, and it's coming from this throne.
Thank you, Jesus. In his presence. Thank you, Jesus. I'm still here. I'm still here. Hallelujah. Can't go until the Lord tell me to go. Holy, 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 Lord. The redeemed worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you. And the angels bow. The redeemed worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy. Tell him he's holy. Tell him he's holy. You are holy. The redeemed worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus. Worship him. Give him thanks. Give him praise. Thank you, Jesus. Behold, the Lord hath proclaimed unto the end of the world. Behold, thy salvation cometh. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work is before him.
Behold, your God holy. Behold him. Behold him. Look upon his face. Behold him. Lord, I behold you today. I behold your beauty today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I behold your beauty today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Worship the Lord. Give him thanks. Give him praise. Give him honor. Thank you, Jesus. My God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm just tarrying in his presence. 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 Thank you, Jesus. I magnify your name, Jesus. See, I love the presence of God. Love the presence of God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. I'm just tarrying in his presence. Thank you, Jesus.
What a joy to worship you with all that is within us, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. People don't like the presence of God, you know, because that is one place you cannot hide who you truly are. That's one place you can't hide who you truly are. So some people don't like worship, they don't like praise, they don't like worship, they don't like the presence of God, because the presence of God will find them out. So people doesn't really like the presence of God. Adam hid himself from the presence of God. My God. Stay in the presence of God. Don't let anything or anyone take you out of the presence of God. Don't let no distraction of the enemy take you out of the presence of God. Stay in the presence of God. Nurture the presence of God. Feed the presence of God. Do fasting. Pray. Read the word daily. Stay in the presence of God. Don't let anything or anyone take you out of the presence of God this morning. Don't be ashamed of the presence of God. Don't be ashamed of the presence of God. The foolish things of this world, God has used to confound the wise, okay? Don't worship God with your lips and your heart is far from him. Worship him. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for tuning in today. Thank you for being a part of this worship and praise. And to listen to the word. But not only to listen to the word, but please apply it. Don't play with your salvation. Please, don't play with it. Especially now, don't play with it. Don't ramp with it. Stay in the presence of God. Remain there. Don't move. Don't move. If you hear this audio video today, this video today, or tonight or tomorrow, whenever, you might be tuning in or listening in. Stay in the presence of God. And if you're not in the presence of God, walk yourself to get into the presence of God. Provoke yourself and get into the presence of God. Today I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord. For those that have found themselves out of your presence, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that right now, Heavenly Father, that you will take off everything that easily beset them this morning. That you will take off, undo the heavy burdens. That you will, oh God Almighty, take them up from where they are and into a place, oh God Almighty, where they could come into your presence. This morning, God Almighty, that you will, oh God Almighty, help them to seek after your presence and to remain there. Father, I pray this morning, God, that you will dwell with them, that you will help them, Father God, that you will help them to stay focused on you. Hallelujah. To be focused on you. Father God, I come against everything that might be in their way right now. Every hindrance. Every hindrance. I pray that you will, oh God Almighty, take away those hindrances right now, so that they may go in your presence. And stay there. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I give you thanks today, Lord. And I pray, God Almighty, that God, that none will be lost. But God, you will save those that seek after you to be saved right now. I pray right now, Father, that they will sink themselves more in you. More of God and less of me. Father, right now, I cover them under your blood. I cover them under your blood. Anyone, oh God Almighty, that may come across this video, oh God Almighty, I cover them under your blood. That you will pass over them. Protect them and keep them safe, Lord. In Jesus' name. If you've not received the Lord as received Jesus as the Lord and Savior, if you have not given your life unto Him today, give your life to Jesus today. Say, Lord Jesus, as I come into your presence, I'm asking you, Lord, to wash me of my sins, O God. Cleanse me, purge me, saturate me, O God. Create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me, your free spirit in me, O God. I promise not to go back to my old ways.
accept me as I come into your kingdom right now? If you've said that prayer, find a Bible-believing church that believes in God, His Word. Find yourself in the house of God, because just now, there wouldn't be no church for you to go to. So my thing is, find a church right now and find yourself under a man of God or a woman of God who is of God. I am currently in Tobago and I worship at Scarborough New Testament Church of God in Tobago, right on top of the hill of Tambourine. My pastor's name is Reverend Ellis Clark. Phone number 868-639-7729. I think we're on YouTube. We're at Pigott Street. The church that I worship in Jamaica is currently Cobbler New Testament Church of God. Cobbler New Testament Church of God. You could go there, fasting services there every Tuesday, Sunday service. You could go there as well. That's my church back in Jamaica. And I'm sure there are other churches that you could find. Find a Bible-believing church and go and worship the Lord.
Lord, we'll never understand your grace. But tonight we stand before your throne, lifting our souls to you.
God bless you. God keep you. And remember, stay in God's presence. Stay in the presence of God. Stay in the presence of God. Sister Maxine, thank you for staying with me for so long. You're keeping me good company. God bless you, my dear. God bless you, my dear. God bless you and keep you. Love you very much. Okay? Bye-bye.